The bruise comes first, then the rot, then the decay. You see it in a melon, you see it in an apple, you certainly see it in a banana. It gets mishandled, bumped, or dropped, and pretty soon it has that spot on it, that bruise that creates decay. And that happens in people's lives as well. In Isaiah 53, it says, speaking of Jesus, you know, that he was bruised for our iniquities. And when he opened up his ministry there in his hometown in Nazareth, he took the book of Isaiah and he says, I've come to set at liberty them that are bruised. And there's a lot of bruised people in the world. They are mishandled by parents. They have difficulties with peers, all kinds of circumstances in business and life where people feel mishandled, bumped around, and bruised. And many times it takes an experience with Christ to be set free from that. You look in the Bible and, you know, you see David. David was bruised by his own son, by Saul. You see people like Peter on the night of his betrayal, how bruised he was and how he wept. The woman caught in adultery, how she was used by men, even as a trap for Jesus. And Jesus comes to set at liberty them that are bruised. He wants to bring healing. He wants to bring wholeness. He wants to heal you from the inside out. He doesn't so much maybe heal you of the external bruises, but he goes for the heart, because all of us have been through some kind of mishandling, some kind of bruise. And so he says at the very inception of his ministry, I have come to set at liberty them that are bruised. And maybe you've been bruised. So I encourage you to go to the one who can set you free of your bruising. Find your healing, find your health, find your freedom from Christ, who said, I came to set at liberty, I came to set free them that are bruised. He does it. It's amazing, from the inside out.